Well, good afternoon. We really appreciate you spending this time with us, especially since it's such a busy season. Please sit back and enjoy. The season of Advent can be considered a time out for Christians. During this time, the Holy Spirit works in us to inspire our hearts to love and serve others and to strengthen our faith as we live for Christ. It is a time to treasure all that God has done and continues to do for us. Advent is a time to meditate on what truly is important and to share the wonderful message of Christmas with others. As Christian women, we know where our hearts and focus should be as we prepare for Christ's coming. But sometimes the world overpowers us. Please join us in singing Thy Word. The words are on the back of your program. Look forward to Advent and Christmas. To share this, I invited some friends to come, but each gave me excuses. They were all wrapped up in other things. So I drove the church bus to each one's house and told them it's a come as you are party. The bus has unloaded now, and each of my friends has come exactly how I found her. One by one, they'll find their way to our gathering.
Will somebody please help me? I'm all tied up with Christmas.
Well, I would definitely say you are, but what's the meaning of all this?
I'm determined that this year I will not be tied up in knots wrapping gifts until late December 24th. Last year, I didn't even get to the candlelight service. This year, and this time, I will finish early.
It looks like wrapping has finished you. You know, there's another word that sounds almost like wrapped. It is wrapped, R-A-P-T, meaning having been carried away bodily or transported to heaven. If you are so preoccupied, you are losing out on being R-A-P-T wrapped in the wonder of the coming of Jesus. Let's listen to God's words about this.
From Isaiah 9, verse 2 and 6, the people that walked in darkness have seen a great light. They that dwell in the land of the shadow of death, upon them hath the light shined. And for unto us a child is born, unto us a son is given. And the government shall be upon his shoulder, and his name shall be called Wonderful Counselor, the Mighty God, the Everlasting Father, the Prince of Peace.
I guess you are right. Thank you for untying my inside knots and helping me to see the light. And now, will you please set me loose?
Let's give these concerns over to God. Oh my goodness. There. Put them down here. Thank you. Now, if you'll join us in prayer.
Father, your gift is indescribable. You entrust me with your most precious gift, and I admit that some days I have trouble remembering that wonderful truth. Father, I pray that you shine your light so brightly in and through my life this Christmas that others can't help but be drawn to your Son in the manger. Thank you for giving me the only Christmas present that really matters. Amen.
Who is this? The Tin Man from The Wizard of Oz clinking in here? Sorry about the noise, but I've just got to get my baking done. Just how much do you have to do?
Stollen, coffee cakes, cookies by the dozen, and fruit cakes.
Fruitcake is right. Don't you think it's kind of silly to focus so much of your attention on one thing? You are so hot on baking that I hope you are not cool to Jesus' coming. We hear God's word.
From Matthew 1:23, it says, "Behold, a virgin shall be with child and shall bring forth a son, and they shall call his name Emmanuel, which being interpreted is God with us." John 3:16 says, "For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son, that whoever believes in him should not perish, but will have everlasting life."
I have to admit, I've been so busy in the kitchen, my oven never gets time to cool down at all. Maybe I'd better get things in perspective and warm up to what this season is really about, Jesus coming.
Let's give these to God. This might take a while. Got it.
No, we don't. We'll get there. This is a lot of baking
stuff.
It's
hard to give up. Okay. Join us in prayer, please.
Dear Lord, thank you for sending your son to be my savior, born as a lowly child in a stable. Help me to remember the reason for Advent, and help me to share your love with those around me. Strengthen me to remain vigilant and productive as I await that day when he will come again. Amen. Amen.
Join us in singing hymn 331, and if you're able, stand on the last verse.
Thank you.
Did you lose it on Stewardship Sunday?
No, not that pledge. I'll think about Stewardship Sunday, maybe in January. I've got to get my house spotless for the holidays. This has to come first.
We are expecting company at our house. Are you?
Oh, the entrance to our house is like a revolving door at Christmas. Strings of parties, two sets of out-of-towners are coming. It will be a constant stream of people.
What about the special guest? Well, one Advent hymn has the words, "Welcome to Earth, thou noble guest." We have to get our hearts ready in order to welcome him in. Hear God's word.
From Psalm 51, verse 10, "Create in me a clean heart, O God, and renew a right spirit within me." And from Ephesians 1, verses 18 and 19, "I pray that your hearts will be flooded with light so that you can understand the confident hope he has given to those who have called his, those he called his holy people, who are his rich and glorious inheritance."
Thanks for reminding me of what is important. I was planning to celebrate a birthday and forgot the guest of honor. I was so focused on cleaning my house, I forgot to prepare my heart.
It's time to give those things up. Let's put them down here. Perfect. Thank you.
Please join us in prayer. Lord, I confess that I am so easily preoccupied with the things of this world that I forget the real meaning of this Advent and Christmas season. Help me to treasure your coming as a baby and the sacrifice you made to redeem me. Help me to keep my focus on Christ, and in my preparations this season, guide me to do everything for your glory. Amen. Amen.
Hymn 358, the verses are listed in the program.
Thank you.
woman, is your arm broken?
Nearly. I am not quite finished with Christmas cards, but my fingers and hands have had it.
There must be some way around your problem. Could you start earlier? Write less? Use address labels.
I don't know. If I have too many left to do, I don't think I'll get to Advent service on Wednesday night.
I have a friend who sends cards at Easter instead of the busy Christmas season. Another I know only sends cards to out-of-town people that she can't see personally.
Well, something has got to change, but I don't want to stop sending cards. I enjoy receiving greetings from my friends along with all the newsy cards and pictures.
Please don't let this task keep you from attending church services. That's when God can send his Christmas message to you. Let's listen to the word of God.
From John 1, 1 through 5, it says, "In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. The same was in the beginning with God. All things were made by him, and without him was not anything made that was made. In him was life, and the life was the light of men. And the light shines in darkness, and the darkness has not overcome it." From Psalm 100, verses 1 through 5, it says, "Make a joyful noise unto the Lord, all ye lands. Serve the Lord with gladness. Come before his presence with singing. Know ye that the Lord, he is God. It is he that hath made us, and not we ourselves. We are his people, and the sheep of his pasture. Enter into his gates with thanksgiving, and into his courts with praise. Be thankful unto him, and bless his name. For the Lord is good, his mercy is everlasting, and his truth endureth to all generations."
You're right. Christmas can wait, but God's message cannot. See you in church.
Let's give this stress to the one who said, "Do not be anxious about anything." Thank you.
Let's pray. Father, I pray that your work,
your message of love in my heart
and life this season. You have given me good news of great joy. I pray that I live that joy out loud until those who have placed around me
why.
Then give me the courage to tell them about your love for them. In Jesus' name, amen.
Hymn 349.
Thank you.
my goodness, there you are. I've been looking all over for you. Whoa, it looks like you have worn out your charge cards.
You know, this business of gift exchanging just has me frantic and broke.
Why do you let it get so out of hand?
Oh, you know, one thing leads to another. A friend or relative gives you a gift, then you feel obligated to give one in return, and then it just goes and goes. It seems too many people give bigger and better gifts each year. It's so hard to keep up. Then my budget is shattered, and so is my disposition.
Maybe we have to take a step back and take a serious look at why we give gifts. You know that if we would try to match gifts, we could never match the gift God gave us. He gave his very best, his son. What's the best thing you have to give? Here is God's word on that subject.
1 Peter 4, verses 10 and 11. Each of you should use whatever gift you have received to serve others, as faithful stewards of God's grace in its various forms. If anyone speaks, they should do so as one who speaks the very words of God. If anyone serves, they should go and do with the strength of God that God provides, so that in all things God may be praised through Jesus Christ. To him be the glory and the power forever and ever. Amen. Matthew 22, verses 37 to 39, Jesus replied, "Love the Lord your God with all your heart and with all your soul and with all your mind. This is the first and greatest commandment. And the second is like it, love your neighbor as yourself."
Now I see it. I can give all of myself to God and serve him instead of concentrating on all these material things.
Now you are putting yourself in the charge of the master instead of your master charge. Turn over those cards. Well, okay. All of them. Is there more?
Well, one more.
That's it?
That's all.
Okay. That's all. Thank you.
Thank you.
Please join me in prayer. Father, a simple thank you does not seem nearly adequate for the life-changing, soul-saving gift of your son. As I celebrate his birth, I ask that you work peace in my heart, the peace that surpasses all understanding. I am amazed by your vastness and the lengths you go to keep reaching out to me in love. Help me to share your love, to serve others, and to make a difference that will enlarge and expand your kingdom. Thank you, Jesus. Amen.
I'm glad my friends came this afternoon. Let us all try to keep our priorities in order. Please join in singing hymn 344 and stand on the last verse.
Thank you.
Amid the shopping, baking, parties, and other activities of the Advent Christmas season, it is easy to forget what we really need. On these busy days, as he does every day, God invites us to talk with him in prayer. God works through his word in Advent devotions and worship services to help us focus on Christ's coming as a baby. His coming to us today in his word, and his final coming to take us to that winning trophy of heaven. In Holy Communion, God gives us the strength we need to live our lives as his redeemed people. Finally, Advent is also a time to evangelize, to share the wonderful message of Christmas and what it means for the world. When the shepherds came and saw the baby in a manger,
Luke 2:17 tells us, when they had seen him, they spread the word concerning what had been told them about this child.
Sometimes our evangelizing can be soft sell or simple sharing as we select the Christmas card with a nativity scene instead of a snowman, or use Christ-centered Christmas decorations around our home. When our families gather for the holidays, we can include Christmas Eve and or Christmas Day worship services as part of our celebration. We evangelize as the Holy Spirit encourages us to share the meaning of Christmas with neighbors and co-workers. Let us pray together. Lord Jesus came to prepare the way for me, not just any way, the way, the only way to eternal life. By keeping my eyes focused on him and through faith, following his guidance by the power of the Holy Spirit within me, I know he will lead me on a journey that fills me with wonder, awe, and great joy. Help me to share your love with others, serve those in need, and shout the good news. Amen. Please rise if you are able for the last hymn, 837. Thank you. God's richest blessings to you this Christmas as you carry out your mission. Have a blessed, Christ-filled Christmas. Please join us for Christmas cheer and caroling downstairs, and there is an elevator right down the hall if you wish to take it. Thank you for coming.